Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to clear a list. So for example, I have created one list called my list, which contains some of the elements. And I want to clear all these values. So I want to make clear all the list items. So to do this, we have many approaches. So we can use clear method, and we can also initialize the list with a no value, or we can use star equal to zero operator, and we can also use delete method. So these are the different approaches we have. Now we'll see how we can clear the list by using these approaches. Let's go to PyCharm. Now I'll just creating a new Python file. I'll name it as clear a list. Clear a list. And let's take a Python file. Now here, let's say approach one. So in approach one, I'm using a clear method. So how we can use clear method to clear the list. So here I will define a list called my list, which contains 6, 0, 4, and 1. Now after this, after define this list, I'm just printing this list as it is. Let's say print. And here I say my list before clearing or before clear. And here I'm just adding comma and then my list. So before clearing, I'm just printing my list as it is. And after that, I want to clear this. So to clear this, we can directly use clear method. So my list is my variable dot. There is a method called clear. So this particular method will clear the list. So after clearing the list, then again, I'm printing my list here. So my list after clear. So my list before clear and my list after clear. Now again, printing the same my list. Now let us execute. Run clear list. So now before clearing, these are the elements I have 6041. Now after clearing, there are no elements. All right. So this is straightforward method. So clear method is directly available. So this is approach one. So in the next approach, I will show you by using initializing the list with no values. This is another approach. Approach two initializes the list with no values. I'm just commenting this. Again, I will define the list here. My list equal to again 6041. And again, I'm printing the list as usual. So before clearing it. Now, how we can initialize the list with no value? So here I already have this list which contains a number of elements. Again, I will reinitialize this list with no value. So for that, what you can do is just use the same list name equal to and just say put empty bracket. Now the same list variable doesn't have any value now. I have initialize the same variable again with the no values. Now again, print the same list again. So before clearing this list, I'm printing once again. After clearing it, again, I'm printing it. So to clear the list, what I have done is I just reinitialize the list. That's it. Now let us run this and it will give you before clearing this one and after clearing, there are no elements. So this is one more approach. Initialize the list with the no value. And there is one more approach where we can use star equal to zero operator. So basically this particular operator, approach three using star equal to zero, this method removes all the elements of the list and makes it empty. So this particular command or operator star equal to zero will make the list completely empty. Now I'll show you how we can use this particular operator. Now again, I'm just commenting these things. And I will just redefine this array list once again, and I'm printing this list before clearing. So I redefine this list again. I'm printing the list before clearing. So after printing this, what I can do is here I'll say my list star equal to zero. So that's it. So my list star equal to zero. So this particular command deletes the list using star equal to zero. This will basically deletes the list. So after that, again, I am printing my list. So use the same command, my list after clear. Now let us execute. So before clearing, these are the elements. After clear, there are no elements. It is completely empty. Okay. So this is another way we can remove the element from the list, or we can clear the element from the list. Now we have one more approach, fourth approach, using del method, or we can use delt method. So we can also use del method to remove the element from this list. Let me just comment the above one. So again, I'm redefining these two. mylist having some values, and I'm printing the mylist before clearing. Now, how we can clear these values? By using a del method. So by using del method, we can do like this. So let me just put like this mylist, and here I'll say, del keyword. So del mylist, del mylist. And here I need to basically this del keyword we can use to remove the range of elements, or we can remove all the elements. So for example, when I say del mylist, one colon three, right? So this is basically called as a slicing. So if one is representing the starting point, three is representing the ending point. Okay. So when I say del mylist one colon three, one representing this one, zero. So zero and one, and three representing one, two, and four. So one is starting point, three is the ending point. So one means zero and one. So the first position we have a zero, and the third position, let's say we need to count from one, one, two, and three. So when you're counting the starting index, starting from zero, when you're counting the ending index, starting from one. So when I say three means one, two, and three. In the third position, we have a four. So between zero and four, whatever values we have will be deleted. So here there are no values between zero and four. So only zero and four will be deleted, and rest of the value still remains the same. Six and one will be there. So the delete method will delete the range of values. And this is the one thing, let me just bring this. So here I'll say my list directly. See this, what is the outcome we will get? So zero comma four will be deleted. And what are the left here? Six and one will be there. So when I run this code, it will give you only six and one, and rest of the middle values are removed. But now I want to clear all the values, not only middle values, I want to clear everything. So for that, what I can say is, I can simply say, don't specify the starting point and don't specify the ending point. Just say only colon, just say only colon. Now, what does it mean is, if I don't specify any starting index, it will start from the beginning. And if you don't specify any index, ending index, it will go to the till end of the list. Okay. So it will remove everything from the list. So now this particular statement will remove everything from this list. And then again, I am printing the list after removing the elements. So this will remove all the elements, or we can simply say deletes all the elements. Okay, now after removing all, after deleting all the elements, again I'm printing the mylist after clearing it. Let's execute. Now these are the values before clearing, and there is no values after clearing this list. Okay, so this is another approach. So there are four approaches we have seen. One is we can use a clear method. The second approach is we can reinitialize this same variable with no values. And the third approach is we can use star equal to zero approach. And fourth approach is we can use delete method. So these are the four methods we can use, or four approaches we can follow to clear the list. All right. So that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.